The mutton is tender and draped in copious amounts of that pepper. The chicken is moist and juicy all the way down to the bone. And then you have the Guntur chicken, which heroes, no points for guessing, the red Guntur chili. Hi folks, it's a sunny afternoon here in Bengaluru and I hope you're doing well. Well, today we've stepped out to get some lunch. Over the last few weeks, I've been tasting a lot of vegetarian food. Dosa, idli, khara bhat, kesari bhat, vegetarian thalis, meals. So today I thought we would taste some non-vegetarian food to balance out all the vegetarian fare that we've tasted in the last few weeks. We've been tasting some non-vegetarian food as part of our takeaways. But there is nothing like sitting in a restaurant and savoring some non-vegetarian meals. So the restaurant that we've picked up for lunch today is Bhima's, an Andhra restaurant that's been around in Bengaluru for many years now and has acquired quite a following for itself. We've done an episode in Bhima's in the good old days. When I say good old days, only a few months ago. But, you know, this is a new normal and those were the good old days when you didn't have to worry about things, didn't have to worry about masks, sanitizers, so on and so forth. So I've done an episode on Bhima's earlier. If you haven't caught it, take a look here. So today we're going to revisit Bhima's and taste mostly their non-vegetarian fare and also take a look at some of the measures that they have been taking to ensure that things are safe. So we're on Church Street in the heart of Bengaluru CBD. There is life, but it's not as busy as it used to be. Church Street is typically full of hustle and bustle, but of course, thanks to the current situation, that is missing. There is still life, but a mere fraction of what it used to be. Namaskaram Vijay.
How are you?
I'm doing well. Very different circumstances from the last time I was here.
Yeah, a lot of changes have happened. The COVID times, we have to adapt to the new system
and move on. So I'm with Mr. Vijay Kumar, one of the owners here at Bhima's.
This is our delivery.
So basically anybody who comes for takeaway comes here, doesn't enter the restaurant.
No.
And you've got, of course, social distancing markers.
Yes. And then we have a pedal sanitizer.
Okay. So it's about 12:45. In the earlier good old days, this would have been packed by now.
Yes, it would have been jam-packed. So what we did is, we didn't want anybody to wait. In future, if there is any crowd, we like to make them just sit upstairs.
So you have a waiting area that you kept upstairs. Even the waiting area is socially distanced.
Yes.
So basically, you don't want people waiting out there and congregating at the gate. Have you had people using the waiting room?
Not yet.
But now you're set to go.
Yes, set to take the crowd, handle the crowd. We don't give the menu cards to them.
Oh, there's no menu cards anymore. So you basically scan this. And I can see that you've also minimized the seating here.
This was 100-seater. Now we have reduced it to 50.
50.
50.
All right. So people can sit here. They cannot sit here.
Yes.
They can sit there.
Yes.
So basically there's good distance between
everyone. And we have 4-seater to 2-seater again here.
All right.
So we have 4 people, we'll allow them to sit here. If they have 6, we can ask them to share it.
But this is the distance?
Distance they have to maintain.
Okay, so even if there's a table of 6, 4 have to sit there, 2 can sit here.
2 have to sit.
6 cannot sit together.
No.
Okay, so you've sealed off one of the wash basins there.
Yeah.
So you can only use one wash. So the last time around, we had our meal here in the air-conditioned section, which is now, of course, not operating. Also, I guess from an air conditioning point of view.
Yes, air condition and...
You want it to be open, you want the air to kind of circulate.
Yes.
And also this corridor, so they don't want people moving back and forth.
So this is our kitchen.
So there's social distancing here too.
Yes.
So how do you ensure that the plates, etc. are sanitized?
This is the Winterhalter machine, which washes all the utensils. And our water is about 88 degrees.
80 degrees. So it's washed to 80 degrees, so it kind of fills anything that may be on it. And the people who are handling it, are they handling with gloves?
Gloves. Everyone are handling with gloves.
Okay.
This is the white rice which we are doing, and there's a biryani happening there.
The biryani happening.
Yeah.
I can definitely see that the activity level here is a lot
less.
Less than what we saw the last time we came here. Oh, so that steam rice is done.
Steam.
So of course out here at Bhima's, it's traditional recipes, but recipes that are finished in modern ovens like the combi oven there. So you basically ensure that you have the taste of tradition, but everything is cooked perfectly and also hygienically at the right temperature. On that note, let's get to the restaurant and savor some lunch here at Bhima's. I'm hoping to taste some hearty non-vegetarian dishes. Let's go. It's been a while since we've savored a non-vegetarian meal outside. I'm really looking forward to this. You're in an Andhra restaurant, you have to do the chili chicken. So one chili chicken we'll do. Mutton pepper fry we will do. Or we'll do the guntur. So we'll do a fish fry. So we will do mutton jeera biryani. And we will also do one chicken biryani. It's been a while since we've had a banana leaf set before us in a restaurant. I like the fact that this banana leaf is spotlessly clean. There's no dirt at all on my hands. This is the tradition of moistening the leaf. It already gets your taste buds excited. Of course, you have all the condiments. There's some gongura here, some parupula podi, which is the gunpowder, and there's some pickle. And of course, the chili, the curd chili, if you were having the meal. But today we're going to savor mostly the non-vegetarian part of the menu here. In all the times that I've been visiting Bhima's, I've never seen a restaurant as quiet as this. There's me and a couple of other guests in the restaurant at this time, and it's 1:30. Well, we have all our dishes on the table. Well, most of them. The biryanis will arrive a little later, but let's survey what we have. We have the fish fry. This is of course a kingfish, naped in a nice masala and fried. And then we have the chicken. When you're dining Andhra style, you have to do the chili chicken with copious amounts of green chili. You know, this is going to be a dish that's going to set your palate on fire. Staying with chicken, we also have the guntur chicken. While the chili chicken is an ode to the heat, the vivacious heat of the green chili, the guntur chicken is derived from the guntur chili, and that's what you find in this chicken. So you have the red guntur chili that makes up for the spicing in that dish. And then we have the mutton pepper fry. This is a dish that we tasted the last time as well. Mutton cooked with tons of pepper. And since we had the banana leaf right here in front of us, I said let's also call for some rice because I want to taste the rice with the parupula podi. And then when you did that, I also got some of the pappu and some vendekai kura with it, the lady's finger. So let's just begin with a bit of rice. You know, you're sitting here, you have a banana leaf in front of you, you have some rice, you have that papla podi, the gunpowder, and a copious amount of ghee. This is the way to begin an Andhra meal. You have the buttery notes of the ghee and that papla podi, the spiced lentil powder that coats your palate. In a manner of speaking, just sets the tone for a spicy meal here at Bhima's. Let's go with that fish fry. So it's a thin slice of fish. The advantage to this is the fact that you will taste the spices, you will taste the masala. You can see that the skin has been fried to a crisp around the edges. A simple fish fry, the right amount of spicing, and that fish is fresh. Get some of the lemon. You know, one of the beautiful things about a fish fry is that it doesn't need much. You have some chili, you have some turmeric, perhaps some garlic, some ginger garlic paste that goes into that marinade. That's all. And beyond that, it's the flavor of the fish, it's the freshness of the fish that does the job. If you have fresh fish, you'll get a decent fish fry. And that's what this fish fry at Bhima's is all about. It's a fish fry that's done well, won't knock your socks off, but tasty nonetheless. I like the intense flavor that you get from the fish skin. In fact, that's where all the flavor is. Moving on from the chicken, I'm going to go for the Bhima's chili chicken. Now, the chili chicken is a staple at any Andhra restaurant. You got tons of chili that make for the gravy. So most of the chili chickens tend to be greenish in color. This one is a greenish brown. So I guess that chili chicken gravy has been roasted to develop the color. That chicken is moist, having soaked up all that masala of that chili chicken gravy. The moment you place this in your mouth, your tongue gets numb with the spicy green chili assault. I'm sweating at the back of my head, and I've just had one morsel of that chili chicken, and that chicken has soaked up all the spicy notes of that green chili. The chicken is moist and juicy all the way down to the bone. If you like your food spicy, if you are brave enough to withstand the assault of that green chili, this is certainly a dish to order when you're here at Bhima's. I'm on fire, but I can't resist tasting some more of that chili chicken. Out here, they really cook their meats well. You know, sometimes when you're eating chicken, especially with some gravies, you find that the chicken is dry on the inside, but this one is not. This is juicy all the way in. Spicy, I'm sweating buckets at the back of my head, but there's a vicarious pleasure to savoring this dish. There's also some skin here that's clinging to the chicken. And that skin conveys the fat of the bird. When it comes to chicken, a lot of the fat and also a lot of the flavor is in the skin. So typically in most preparations, they do away with the skin. But if you happen to chance upon some skin, do savor it with that meat. It adds a certain depth of flavor to chicken. Well, the restaurant is beginning to get crowded and also beginning to get noisy. I think after that chili chicken, I want to savor some rice with some pappu, the spinach pappu. I need the respite that this pappu will provide from the spicy chili notes of the chili chicken. That pappu is warm and creamy with a slightly tart edge. Time though to go for some of that mutton pepper fry. The mutton is soft and yields to the touch without any pressure. The mutton is tender and draped in copious amounts of that pepper, which is what you taste. After all, this is a mutton pepper fry. What I also like is there's a bit of fat in the meat, which lends it its flavor, its fulsome flavor. So out here at Bhima's, while the recipes are traditional, they cook the meats in the combi ovens. So what that allows for is for the meats to cook completely, yet because it's cooked in a steaming sort of a method, it traps all the moisture, all the juices of the meat and keeps it intact. So what you have on the bite is a juicy, flavorful piece of meat. And there's also a fair bit of fat that's clinging onto the meat, lending its deep, savory notes. There's also plenty of onion that goes into this mutton pepper fry. So you're also tasting the deep brown flavor tones of the onion. And of course, it's the pepper that reigns supreme on the palate. So the pepper brings its spice, but it's a different spice as opposed to the spice of the green chili. While the green chili attacks you full on with its spicy fervor, the pepper, on the other hand, is more calmer, is more gentler, but is also a lot more warmer on the palate. The sort of heat that you find slithering down your throat. That's the heat, that's the warming heat of the pepper in that mutton pepper fry. I think I'm going to go for some of that chapati here with that pappu. I think that pappu helps cleanse some of the spice from the palate. The creamy lentils envelop your tongue, providing for some respite from that heat. And also some vegetable here, if you want a bit of fiber. And this is the lady's finger, the bendekai, the bendekai kura. On that note, it's time to move on to the Guntur chicken. So the Andhra meal experience in Bengaluru is all about the spice. And the dishes that we've ordered certainly are testament to that. So you have the chili chicken, which is full on in that spicy assault of the green chili, copious amounts of green chili. The gravy is green chili. And then you have that mutton pepper fry that, though not as aggressive as the green chili, certainly stays on the palate with its gentle warmth. And then you have the Guntur chicken, which heroes, no points for guessing, the red Guntur chili. So while you do taste the spicy tones of the Guntur chili, there's plenty of coconut that makes for the gravy in this preparation. So the creaminess of the coconut balances out against the spicy notes of the chili. So thankfully, though it heroes the Guntur chili, this is not a preparation that will have you sweating at the back of your head or reach for that glass of water. In fact, this preparation is quite gentle on the palate. This is also the sort of preparation that would go very well with some rice or chapati. I think there's also some tomatoes that go into the Guntur chicken that also lends the dish a bit of acidity. So you have the toasted creamy notes of the coconut, you have the acidity of the tomato, which balances out against the heat of the Guntur chili, which by itself is quite spicy. Well, it's time to taste the biryanis now here at Bhima's. And we have two biryanis that we're doing. So one is, of course, the traditional Andhra style, the Nellore style biryani that's served here at Bhima's. And of late, they've also launched what they call the Jeera biryani. This is basically a biryani that's made with the Jeera sambar rice. And this is Bhima's ode to the local Donne biryani. So typically, I would begin with the chicken biryani first and the mutton biryani later. But for two reasons. One, I've not tasted this Jeera biryani here at Bhima's before. And secondly, I feel the flavors of the Nellore style biryani may perhaps be deeper because of the spices that go into the Nellore biryani, as opposed to the green paste, the marinade that goes into that local style biryani here. So therefore, I suspect the flavors for this will be a lot fresher and perhaps not as deep as the flavors of the Nellore style biryani. So therefore, we will taste the Jeera biryani first. This biryani is nice and warm and aromatic too. You can definitely taste the flavors of the green masala that has gone into it. The coriander, the mint, that's what you definitely taste. Also, this is a typical spice that goes into a local style biryani. This is the Marat Mogu or the Kapok bud, which goes into the local style biryani. And you also taste the heat of the green chili. That's part of the masala that goes into the making of this biryani. Oh, that meat is tender. The meat pulls away from the bone the moment you just apply the slightest of pressure. And that meat is pink and juicy all the way in. That meat is also sheathed in a bit of fat. Oh, that meat just slides off the bone. It's cooked as well as that. I love the deep flavors of the meat. Let's taste some with the rice. The deep, unctuous flavors of the meat and the fat that it's sheathed in takes over the flavor of the green masala. Go for some of the curd just to cleanse our palate. That's hopefully cooled things down in the mouth. Let's go for that chicken biryani. This biryani, of course, is made with the basmati rice, unlike the last biryani, which is made with the Siraka sambar rice. This is a long grain basmati rice. So even when you hold the rice in your fingers, you can certainly make out the difference. The rice here is separate, whereas the rice and the Siraka sambar clumped together a wee bit. There's also bits of pineapple that go into the making of a Nellore style biryani. And that's certainly something that you taste. I was worried that the spicing of the Jeera rice biryani would take over the spicing of this Andhra style biryani, but no, none of that. In this biryani, you taste the flavor of the hard spices. the cinnamon, the cardamom, perhaps some nutmeg, the bay leaf, that goes into the spicing of this biryani. The meat is pink and tender. Chicken has absorbed the flavors of the spices that have gone into this biryani. Some biryani with the rice. That chicken is moist. Moist and juicy. What's interesting when you're dining at a restaurant like Bima's is that the fries are the ones that are spicy. Whether it's the chili chicken or the mutton pepper fry. But when it comes to the biryanis are mellow, almost gentle on the palate when compared to some of those dishes. More than the chicken, I'm enjoying the delicate spicing of this rice. The aromas of the spices, the cardamom, the cinnamon wafts through your palate. And that's really what makes an impression and remains with you long after you've savored this biryani. I've enjoyed my meal here at Bima's. And there seem to be many others who are enjoying their meal here too. When we came in, there were only two or three other people in the restaurant. But an hour later, the restaurant is packed, of course packed to its 50% capacity, which is what is allowed in the current situation. So I've enjoyed all the dishes here on the table, from that fiery spicy chili chicken to the mutton pepper fry with its warming peppery notes, and that guntur chicken, which I expected to be spicy but was the exact opposite though. The coconut in that preparation working well to calm down the aggression of that guntur chili. The biryani is too very interesting. The Siraga Samba biryani was a first for me. I quite enjoyed it, especially the fresh flavors of that green masala. Well, as for the Nellore style biryani, this is what they do best. And the biryani that I tasted today stood testament to that. But beyond the food, there's a lot that's happening on the restaurant to ensure that things are safe for patrons. From the social distancing that starts even before you enter the restaurant, to the temperature check, to the sanitization, to the spaced out tables that have reduced capacity by 50%, to the fact that everybody who's serving you is wearing a mask, face shield. Even when you look at the kitchen, you have the cooks who are socially distanced, wearing masks. And of course, out here, they cook in those combi ovens, which ensures that the food is cooked to the right temperature to ensure that it's not just tasty, but also completely safe. So I've enjoyed lunch here, and I hope you've enjoyed this episode too. Until the next one, stay safe, stay very, very safe, and happy eating. If you'd like to support the work that we do at Food Lovers TV, do consider joining our membership community on YouTube by hitting the join button below or on the homepage. You could pledge a nominal sum and receive special privileges like behind the scenes footage, shoot updates, access to live Q&As, and a lot more. You could support us on a Patreon page as well. For more info, check out the links in the description below. If you like this video, don't forget to subscribe, like, share, and leave a comment below. Happy eating!